We end the week with a Cape Coral woman's unusual path toward boxing history.
Here is NBC2's Sean Martinelli with tonight's story to share.
Consider it the golden era of boxing.
Ali cuts the mile while he's in trouble.
Throughout the 60s and 70s, greats like Ali, Frazier, and Leonard captivated the country with their performances.
A right hand by Leonard.
And during that time, Carol Polis of Cape Coral couldn't have cared less.
I never watched. I had no interest. None. Zero. Nothing.
Which makes her an ever so unlikely candidate to be considered one of the sport's trailblazers.
I would say I got into boxing on a fluke, but I made something of it.
50 years ago, Carol was married to a boxing referee who took her to a match and handed her a scorecard.
And he gave me, and I mean this seriously, no more than a 20-second lesson to be a judge.
That's all the time Carol needed to make an impression.
He turned it in, and the commissioner said, I like it better than the men.
Over the next year, Carol studied the sport while raising 4 kids.
I remember exactly how I felt, February 1st, 1973.
The day Carol did something.
Yep.
No woman had ever done before.
This way as Bonds tries to fight back. Bonds is hurt now.
She became the first female boxing judge in the world.
The men in the beginning would say, you should be home baking. I said, I use the kitchen as a breezeway to get out of the house.
The champion is now finding his opponent with jabs and is looking better.
Over the course of her career, Carol judged 143 professional contests, including more than 24 title fights and several world championships.
I was determined that they could see I could be just as good, in fact, a better judge than most of the men.
Now retired, Carol has nothing left to prove. Earlier this year, she was inducted into Pennsylvania's Boxing Hall of Fame.
You have to want something badly enough to give it your best shot and always do the best you can.
Words from a woman who saw one of boxing's glass ceilings and delivered a knockout blow. In Cape Coral, Sean Martinelli, NBC2.